Okay students, so next is question number 6. These questions are very simple. Okay, so again see, the radius of a circle is increasing, means the circle is becoming bigger and bigger, right? The radius of circle increasing at the rate 0.7 centimeter per second. So your circle radius is becoming bigger and bigger, means the circle area also will become bigger, right? Or circumference also, the length of this boundary also will become bigger when the circle will become, right? So they have given at what rate this radius is becoming bigger, means derivative of radius is given. So we will let r be the radius, you write down that one, okay? Then dr by dt is equal to how much? It's given 0.7 centimeter per second, okay? Now what I will do with this, let's see what they have asked you to find out. What is the rate? Again, derivative you have to find, right? You have to find how fast. What is the rate of increase of its circumference? So this time also you have to find out at what rate the circumference. Now see, when your circle will become bigger, what will happen? Its circumference, this is called circumference, okay, with the length of the boundary. So this boundary is your circumference. So when your circle will become bigger, obviously your circumference also will become bigger and bigger with some speed, right, with some rate. So we have to find out that rate, okay? So how to find out that rate of circumference we have to find out. So let circumference of circle, what is the formula? Circumference, let me name it as C, denoted by C, okay? Circumference formula is twice pi r, right? So we have to find out the rate of, means that how fast the circumference is becoming bigger, increasing, they have said, right? Means we have to find out d with respect to time, c, dc by dt, rate of circumference we have to find with respect to time. So d dt of 2 pi r, so which will be how much? 2 pi will be outside, dr by dt, right? Dr by dt, we know what is the value. So 2 pi into 0.7, so it will be 1.4 pi, okay? So this will be the rate of increasing circumference, right? Now that's it, they have asked that much only, right? They have not asked anything about this one else, okay? This is the only thing they have asked, so this will be your answer. Next, you have to write down the unit also here. Now the circumference is what? Is the length, right? So centimeter per time second, okay? Next, number 7, I will do directly, okay? Number 7 also, the length x of a rectangle. Now this time they have said rectangle, all of you know, opposite sides are equal, okay? The length x of a rectangle is decreasing at the rate 5 centimeter per minute. So this is suppose x length, okay? This is your width, or you can say breadth, okay? Now this time the rectangle size is becoming smaller and smaller with some speed, okay? So rate of change of its length is given, and it is decreasing, they have said. You can see the length x of a rectangle is decreasing at the rate of 5 centimeter per minute. Means in 1 minute, it used to decrease how many? 5 centimeter. Okay, so this time decreasing rate is given. So d, let x is given, right? Dx by dt, they have given 5. This time we will put minus. Why? Because we note derivative decreasing. Derivative means the rate it is decreasing means negative, right? If it is increasing, positive. So this time also you can see negative sign is not given in the question, but you need to understand that one, okay? Decreasing at the rate 5 centimeter per minute, so it will be negative. And I have already discussed, right, increasing and decreasing function. Anyway, so here next and the width y. So this time width is how much? Y. So length it is decreasing, they didn't say anything with, about width till now, okay? So width is increasing, okay? So the rectangle is its length is decreasing like this, but its width is increasing, okay? Width is becoming bigger and bigger. So rate of change of width is given, rate of change of width is given, okay, with respect to time. This is your width. Width is given by y, they have said, right? Width y is increasing at the rate of 4 cm. So 4 cm per minute. Per minute. Okay, this time this will be positive. Why? Because width is increasing. Okay, next. Okay, when x equal to 8 and y equal to this, find the rate of change. Again, they have said find the rate of change of perimeter and area of rectangle. So perimeter, you know formula, right? Perimeter means what? Length of boundary. So this plus this plus this plus this will give you perimeter. This plus this plus this plus this, or you can say, okay, the formula is 2x plus 2y, right? Or you can write 2x plus y. Okay, you know this, right? 2 length plus breadth, perimeter of rectangle. So we have to find, okay, let perimeter, or what I will do, P, let me denote it by P, is equal to perimeter is how much? 2x plus y. So rate of change of perimeter we have to find. Rate of change of perimeter. So we have to find dP by dt, which is equal to dt twice x plus y. So 2 is constant, take it outside. Now here be careful. From your midterm exam only I have understood that you don't give importance to bracket, some student, okay? So try to put importance here also in bracket. Don't ignore this bracket, okay? Now you can see 2 into this it is. So when I take this constant outside, it will be 2 into this whole differentiation. So 2 into whole differentiation means this d dt, it will be inside bracket. Whatever you will get from here, everything must get multiplied here, okay? This step is not necessary to write down, but some student used to make mistake here also, that's why I'm writing, okay? So 2 into dx by dt plus dy by, in differentiation I can split, right? Whenever it is plus, so this will be 2 into dx by dt is how much given? Minus 5 plus this will be 4, so minus plus minus, so it will be 2 into minus 1, right, which is equal to minus 2. So you can see as your length is decreasing with this rate and width is decreasing with this rate, the perimeter will decrease by this one. Means whatever is perimeter here, when its length is decreasing with this rate and this rate its width is increasing, then perimeter means length of the boundary, whatever it was here at the when it was decreasing with this and increasing with this, its perimeter will be also decreasing, okay? Means length of boundary also will keep on decreasing with minus 2 rate, okay? Okay, next, they have also, this is A, right? A they have given, yes. Next, B, area of rectangle, rate of area, let, this is B, let A is equal to, that is area of rectangle, in bracket I will write, A, okay, is equal to how much? Now area of rectangle, you know, x into y, length into breadth, right? Area of rectangle. So I have to find rate of change of area. Let me write A first here. dA by dt you have to find. So dxy by dt, which is equal to, this is uv form. So x I will keep as it is, I will differentiate y with respect to t, plus y I will keep as it is dx by dt. So x into dy by dt is minus, no, dy by dt is 4, sorry. So 4x y into minus 5, that is minus 5y, okay? So 4x minus 5y. So they have asked you when your x is equal to 8 and y equal to this, find the rate of change of perimeter and area of rectangle. So here we don't have any option, right, to put in first case, you can see. So in this second case we can put in place of x 8 and in place of y 6, and we will see at this values which is given to you, at this value what is the rate of change of area. So put 8 here, 6 here, and solve it, that's it. Okay, so it will be 4 into 8 here minus 5 into 6 here, 32 minus here 30, so which is equal to 2. So positive this time, right? So if it is positive, we know this is area, right? Centimeter square per second. Okay, this is the unit. So area of rectangle. This time positive, so is increasing. So area is increasing, right? With rate what? Increasing with rate of change of, at the rate also I can write, right? At the rate 2 centimeter square per second. Here also you write down, okay? For this also you can write down. After this step, you can write down after this step, okay? Here also conclusion you can write down. Therefore, the perimeter of rectangle, you can write, is decreasing. This time negative, right? Is decreasing. You write down here, okay? The, after this step only you have to write down this. The perimeter of a rectangle is decreasing at the rate minus 2 centimeter. At the rate 2 centimeter. Don't put minus here. By the word decreasing only, they will understand that it's negative, okay? 2 centimeter per second, okay? Here I will write down for you, okay? You write down after this step only. The perimeter of rectangle, okay, is decreasing. Why decreasing I have said? Because minus 2 I got, right? Rate of change of perimeter. Decreasing at the rate 2 centimeter per second. Don't put minus here, okay? By the word decreasing only we understand it will be minus, okay? Next is question number 8. Exactly same. The balloon which always remains spherical on inflation, right, is being inflated by pumping in. So your balloon is inflated, mean they are putting air inside, right? So when you put in air inside, what will happen? The size of the balloon will keep on increasing, right? So they have said is being inflated, means they are putting air, by pumping in 900 cubic centimeter of gas per second. So they are putting how much? 900 cubic centimeter gas per second. So means what? They have given the rate of change of balloon size, right? It's balloon, and the balloon size is obviously when you put 900 centimeter per centimeter, so obviously it will keep on increasing. So they have given the rate of change of your size of the balloon, right? And it is increasing, so positive value. So and with the unit also you can understand if you have any confusion. Cubic centimeter per second, they have said cubic centimeter is the unit of volume, okay? So let V be the volume of spherical balloon, okay? Spherical balloon, you write down that. Now given dv by dt is equal to how much? 900 centimeter cube per second. So this is given to you. Now what I will do with this volume, we know the unit formula, right? What is the volume of sphere? 4 by 3 pi r cube. I told you, that's why your surface area concept must be clear. All the formulas you need to know well, okay? So your high school concept obviously will be needed. So this is volume of this one. So let me write down volume here, d dt. Okay, let r also, we have to mention that, let r be the radius of sphere. So see, when your spherical balloon is inflated with air here, what will happen? Its size will become bigger and bigger. And they have said, you have seen, right, balloon actually it's like oval also, right? But they have strictly mentioned here it's spherical shape. That's why we are using spherical formula. So it remains spherical. If you inflate it air also, then also it will remain sphere, they have said, right? So it remains sphere means what? Now when you inflated air inside the balloon, obviously its radius will become bigger and bigger, yes or no? So you can see they have said in this question, find the rate at which the radius of the balloon increases when the radius is 15 centimeters. So first find the rate at which the radius of the balloon increases, means what you have to find? Dr by dt, okay? So to find dr by dt, let's solve this. What you will get from here, let r, I have already mentioned, right, this will be pi r cube is equal to 900. So you can see this d, okay, pi r, 4 by 3 pi r cube. I have not written 4 by 3 anyway. So from this, what I can do, see, you can, to find out dr by dt, I need to get equation of this one, right? Right now, separately, I cannot find out dr by dt. From here only, we can find out. You can see we have equation. Okay. So what I can do is, constant, I can take it outside, pi. Now, dt of r cube, 900, which implies 4 by 3, let's bring that side, and pi also. Now this will be 3r square dr by, you can see dr by dt, we got it here. So everything will bring this side, 900 by 4 by 3, let me put it here only, pi, 3 got cancelled, okay. So 4 pi r square will come down this side, r square, okay. So I have to find dr by dt, dr by dt will be how much? I have brought this one all this side, right? So obviously only dr by dt will be left in the left side. So if I solve this one, how much I will get? 4 times 2r 8, 1 goes here, 2r 8, 2 goes here, 5r 20, right? So 2 to 5. Now pi, shall I leave like this, or they have given anything about pi? They didn't say anything about pi, right? So anyway, so this will be 225 by pi into r square. R is how much given now? Okay, let me write first r square here. At r is equal to 15 centimeter, dr by dt will be how much? Rate of change of radius, 225 by pi into r square. R square means 15 square. Okay, so 225 into pi, by pi into 15 into 15. So I can cancel this. 5 times 3 here, 5 times 420, 2 goes here, 5. So 5 times again 3 here, 5 times 9 r, right? So 3 times 3. 3 into 3, 9, 9, 9 will get cancelled. So what will we will get here? 1 by pi. So unit also we have to write, radius unit is centimeter per second. Okay, so they have given in terms of second only, right? Where it is? Yeah, in terms of second they have given question. So here also time second only. Unit don't forget to write down, okay? So what you can write? The radius of spherical balloon is, again positive we got, is increasing at the rate 1 by pi centimeter per second. Okay, so this will be your answer. So I don't think you are finding it tough, this one. Okay, next, number 9. Okay, I will do it here. Number 9, what they have said, a balloon which always remains spherical has a variable radius. Now what do you mean by this? A balloon always remains spherical whose radius is variable. Radius is variable means, variable means what? Changeable. So it might become bigger or smaller. Okay, radius is changeable. So radius changeable means what? The size of the spherical. If you change the radius, if you make the radius bigger, then what will happen? Your sphere will become bigger. If you make the radius smaller, then your size of the sphere will become small. So it depends on radius only, right? So if radius is variable, obviously the size of, or the volume, you can say it is changeable. The spherical balloon volume is changeable. Okay, so let's see what they have asked you to find. So first thing, from the step we have understood that the radius is changing, means it might be increased or decreased. Let's see what they have said more. Find the rate. So rate means derivative you have to find, right? Find the rate at which its volume, means volume rate, volume derivative you have to find. With respect to what? Time or what? Find the rate at which its volume is increasing. So obviously first thing, it will be positive, we know. Is increasing with the radius. With respect to radius you have to find. Okay. So find the rate of volume with the radius when the later is 10 centimeter, means when it will become 10 centimeter. Later means what? After inflated air here inside, what will happen? The sphere will become bigger and bigger. So later, when it was 10 centimeter, what is the rate of volume they are asking? Okay, means r, when it is, simple, they have asked in a different way, when r is equal to 10, what will be the rate of change of volume they are asking. So first we will find out dv by dr, right? I hope this is clear. They have asked, find the rate at which its volume is increasing with the radius. Find the rate at which its volume is increasing, means volume is becoming bigger with the radius, with respect to radius. Okay, this time not with respect to time. So first you write down, let V be the volume, R be the radius of spherical balloon. Okay, after that, according to question, you can write dV by dr is equal to, not according to question, actually they have not given anything according to question, right? We have to solve for find the rate at which, and this one is okay, nothing is given information, not according to question, we know, or to find dV by dr, right? So dV by dr means dV is what? Volume of sphere. What it will be? 4 by 3 pi r cube, right? So let's differentiate this one. So this time 4 by 3 pi will come outside, d r cube by dr. Okay, so 4 by 3 pi, this will be how much? 3 r square. That's it. You will not get here dr by dt. Don't write dr. Most students, what they used to do after this, they used to write dr by dt. Last time the independent variable was t, here r, that's why you got dr by dt. This time independent variable is what? Dr. So this time what you will get? Dr by dr, so which will be 1 only. Okay, it's like x cube, this is also x, it's like formula only. So it will stop here. After this, now this will be your rate of change of volume with respect to radius. It's given, right? It's, we have already find out this. Now what they have asked you to find, when your radius is 10 cm, so at r is equal to 10 cm, find out. Okay, 3 will get cancelled first thing here, right? So this can be more simplified, r square, so 4 pi r square. So dv by dr, okay, when your r is equal to 10, how much? 4 into pi into r, we will put 10 square, r square, right? It is 10 square means 100 into 4, 400 pi unit centimeter cube per centimeter. Okay, don't write a second here, it is radius now, radius is centimeter, and don't cancel this. Okay, so therefore the volume of a spherical balloon is positive, we got, right, is increasing at the rate 400 pi centimeter cube per centimeter. Okay, don't make mistake while writing this unit.